Hello, viewers. Were you ticklish growing up? For many people, tickling can be a pet peeve. In this video, we are going to learn about how tickling works. Tickling makes our body react. It's a reflex action. Did you know that tickling has a funny effect on our brains? It has often been speculated that tickling can help people feel less fear or anxiety. Mothers may have a habit of tickling their babies to make them smile. Kids might even do this in school to each other. When you think about tickling, you may even have memories of your friends tickling you at some point in your life. This is because tickling stimulates a part of our brain and opens us up to becoming more vulnerable. The laughter that comes in response to tickling is a result of the stimulation. If you're being tickled, your brain will release dopamine, which is a feel-good chemical. This is why when you think about tickling, you may naturally begin to smile. Now, you might be wondering, why do we get into a defensive position when we know we're about to be tickled? Well, the reason is again the stimulation. You see, while it helps us open up and decreases our sense of fear, it's also the part of our brain responsible for our reaction to fear and anxiety. Let's simplify it. There are many different parts of the brain, out of which the amygdala and the hippocampus are responsible for fear and anxiety. When you get tickled, these areas of the brain get stimulated and a tiny amount of dopamine is released. As a result, you feel less fear. Although it is still a part that stimulates fear and anxiety, while this fear and anxiety doesn't come out like it usually does, it finds a way out in the form of us assuming defensive position when we realize someone's going to tickle us. When it comes to tickling, English naturalist, geologist, and biologist Charles Darwin stated that it's like a physical joke. Why did he think so? Well, because of our reactions. As we mentioned earlier, when we're being tickled, we often burst into laughter. Although researchers have concluded that tickling isn't really a joke. In fact, although we may appear to be laughing, we may internally want the other person to stop. In a study that was conducted in 2005, it was found that while they were reacting with laughter to both stand-up comedy and tickling, the brain responses were different. While watching stand-up comedy, the part of the brain associated with happiness was stimulated, so it could be concluded that they were genuinely happy. When it came to tickling, we already told you which part of the brain that stimulates. Huh, that must mean tickling is a really horrible thing, right? Well, no, not really. You see, tickling your ears can actually be good for your heart. In another study, participants were tickled in the ear with electromagnetic devices. Most of the participants who applied for this study had one or the other form of heartbeat irregularities. When they were tickled, they felt a sudden change in their heartbeat. Those who had a low heartbeat felt a sudden surge in their heartbeats increase to match that of a healthy person. While we don't recommend trying this exercise with an electronic device, you could always tickle someone you like on the ears, as it would be good for them. After all, they can't do it themselves. No one is capable of tickling themselves, and here's why. The human brain identifies the difference between being touched and touching someone through tickling. The chemical reaction in your brain is different while touching something, in comparison to when you're being touched. This is perhaps why you can't tickle yourself. Another interesting point to mention is that experts consider being ticklish as an important evolutionary trait. Psychologists believe that being ticklish is related to a person's self-awareness. They claim that the more ticklish you are, the better your body reflexes are. So if tickling is great, do animals also feel ticklish? Well, yes, they do. If you don't believe us, try tickling a kitten or a puppy. You'll notice them react to it. You may even see them smile. Although don't overdo it, as we mentioned earlier, while they may react to it, they may not like it. Kittens in particular prefer cuddles over tickles. This brings us to a study that was conducted on rats. Rats love being tickled and respond with giggles and smiles. While you and I may not be able to hear it, they do so in an ultrasonic frequency. For this experiment, the researchers tickled the rats and found that it helped to lower levels of fear they had for humans. Quite interesting when you think about it. Whoa, who would have known that tickling had sophisticated brain functions involved, let alone the amount of research that's been done on the subject? We aren't done yet, though. Along with the hippocampus, tickling activates another very interesting part of the brain known as the hypothalamus. Yes, we've already talked about the hypothalamus in our video, Why Do We Get a Fever? If you haven't checked it out, we suggest that you do. It's the part of the brain that increases our temperature when it detects any form of viral or bacterial infection. As a result, we end up with a fever. So, what role does the hypothalamus play in tickling? Well, you see, the hypothalamus is also responsible for our fight-or-flight tendency when faced with audacious challenges. This is why, while we want the other person to stop, we also have a tendency to run away when tickled. It's also a reflex action, and the hypothalamus only wants the best as usual. So, it can't raise the body temperature to kill the infection when you're being tickled. It triggers a response to move away so that you don't get harmed. In a way, the hypothalamus is our hero. Are you ticklish? Have you ever been tickled? Let us know in the comment section below. We'd love to hear from you.
Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.